after another big ceremony that the world is waiting for, if you thought a royal wedding was just glitz and glamour, fancy gowns and castles, think again. Marrying into the royal family is not a cakewalk. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's wedding breaks several traditions, but there are some rules that even a royal bride cannot break. Take a look.
She is set to be married into one of the most exclusive families. And Meghan Markle has her hands full. Wedding invites, her wedding dress, the reception dinner. All seem like the smallest of concerns when the soon-to-be royal has only a few days left to master the royal etiquette. From curtsying to Queen Elizabeth to calling her Your Majesty. The American superstar will have to learn her royal lines before joining the ranks of British royalty.
Etiquette and protocol is really important to the royal family. It's been important to royals for centuries. Louis XIV was the first royal that wanted this rule book, these rules as to how to behave in his palace and in his presence. And since then, royals have embraced this, and those rules are there to make people feel, one, to make them understand what's expected of them, but also so they understand what to do and what not to do.
There are several unwritten rules that Markle will have to acquaint herself with. Right from behaving in public to following her seating code for formal dinners. What's interesting is that Markle will have to curtsy to everyone ahead of her in order of precedence, including Prince William and Kate Middleton's children. But what's the right way to bow? How do you descend a staircase like a royal? Who bows to whom? Markle will have to learn it all. And to make that transition smooth, the soon-to-be royal will be trained by a former butler who in the past has trained her husband-to-be and Prince William as well.
The bow is obviously just the neck bow, perfect, and the curtsy, which is the right foot behind the left, toes touch the floor, down a little bit. That was quite good, a bit ballerina, so it's kind of keeping the legs almost kind of together. Nice. So yes, and then perfect. Beautifully done, and hands in, because some people could have put the hands in, we're not penguins.
Okay.
The biggest challenge, though, for Markle would be to measure her words. The actress, who often describes herself as an activist and a humanitarian, will have to curb her views, especially political ones. Markle will have to be aware of the fact that British royals are expected to steer clear of making any overtly political statements in public.
I think that Meghan will cope, but she will find, you know, some of the flummery difficult to bear. I mean, remember, this is a girl who was a gender equality advocate for the United Nations, having to bow and curtsy to the Queen and even Kate Middleton.
Another protocol Markle will have to follow is to never touch the Queen. Touching Queen Elizabeth is considered to be one of the greatest taboos surrounding the British royalty. The pressure is immense, and Markle needs to make sure she gets it right. Because if she doesn't, it ends up becoming front page news. But for someone who is used to public glare and the paparazzi, Markle should be able to steer clear of any embarrassment for the royal family. Being a royal is not an easy feat, and Meghan Markle has a lot on her plate. With just days to go for the much-anticipated royal wedding, the American actress has little time to perfect the art of royal etiquette. Bureau Report, WION.
Words of wisdom, marriage is hard work, royal or no royal. Also getting ready, though, is not just Meghan Markle, the guests carefully chosen by the royals. The list, interestingly, does not include the Prime Minister of Britain, Theresa May, or the Obamas, known as friends of the royals. Just two of the many noteworthy omissions. As for the others, they fall in categories. Those who get to witness the whole event and feast, and those who stand on the margins with their own food. You heard that right. The thought is unpalatable, unimaginable in India. One cannot imagine any guest, least of all a wedding guest, being told to carry their own dinner. I'm still wrapping my head around the idea of the so-called royals doing that.
This is the magnificent Windsor Castle, Queen Elizabeth's favourite weekend home, and the venue for Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding on May 19th. Now contrast this image with groups of people with their picnic lunches sprawled across the lawns outside the castle. A royal wedding and picnic baskets. You would think those images don't go hand in hand. But that's exactly what the Windsor Castle lawns will look like on May 19th when Prince Harry and Meghan Markle tie the knot. In a break from tradition, 1,200 members of the public are invited for the royal wedding. These guests are drawn from all walks of life and from the four corners of the United Kingdom. While this is a welcome move, an announcement that followed has raised several eyebrows. The crowd that is expected to be outside the St. George Chapel for close to 4 hours has been advised to bring in their own food reinforcements. With Kensington Palace announcing that only light refreshments and snacks will be served. Some of the invitees saw this advisory as unfathomable and expressed shock at the lack of hospitality from a family that is worth over $500 million. Reports claim that bring your own food policy was to help keep costs in check for Prince Charles and the British royal family, who will pay for what they called core aspects of the wedding, including the reception, music and flowers. While these 1,200 guests have to make their own arrangements, 600 guests who will attend the ceremony in the chapel will head to a lunchtime reception in the castle. Social media is brimming with outrage and amusement at the same time. Criticizing the royal family for spending taxpayers' money on the wedding, but not feeding the guests they themselves invited. Some even claiming that this was just for a photo opportunity and was only a gimmick by the monarchy. The royal family may have opened the doors for the wedding to the common public, but these guests will not attend the ceremony. They will only be able to watch the couple arrive in their carriage and walk out as a married couple after the ceremony. So for the commoners invited for the royal wedding, it's just going to be a 4-hour long wait, a mere glimpse of the royal couple, and no royal feast. Bureau Report, WION.